Mayor Chappell.
Charles Wick, Los Angeles. Director of the Voice of America. President.
Rally for you Sunday in Elizabeth, city of New Jersey. Solid Democrat city. The turnout was probably one of the biggest in the city. Really inspired by Cuban Americans. It was fantastic. All carrying an American flag. It's on the Viva La Reagan. So it wasn't too bad.
You know, I signed the Marti thing to all. Had to do with it. I was signed already, but I thank all of you for what we've done with that. Why don't we get a little nearer the middle here and get a group picture here?
Vice President. I want to get him in the middle.
Yes. I'll stay over here and I'll stay over here with Ben. I'll stay right here with Ben. I help you too.
It's a story you never hear this enough.
Thank you. I can't get over these wide-angle lenses. There wouldn't be a time when he would have been way out on the floor.
I thought it was a close-up.
Maybe?
We had a satellite press conference this morning from 9:30 to 11:30 with the key capitals of Western Europe. We had Jean Kirkpatrick in New York, two State Department experts on legality in Washington, Prime Minister Adams of Barbados and Prime Minister Compton of St. Lucia. And we had these interrogations from East QB in England and everywhere. It was absolutely a smash. The London Nightly News at 7 o'clock carried the first 11 minutes of these prime ministers and Kirkpatrick. Nobody could have created a better script as to why we went down there, why they needed us.
Well, you'd all be happy to know now that the engineers for the Secretary of are fixing up the roads, and repairing the bridges, and repairing any damage that was done, all repairing buildings that were damaged and so forth. And the medical corps, now that the wounded are out, are now giving vaccinations to the children and doing all kinds of public health type of things.
I guess you've got more suggestions. I know in our city we have more than 40,000 Cubans.
Here's Clyde.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Charlie, that's interesting. God, I'm
going down with a group of pressure on that.
Just a little souvenir to visit him. set of cufflinks.
Oh!
How did you guess?
I'm glad to see John Roswell take on that job.
Oh, yes. That's pretty brave of him to.
Yes, it is.
And of his company to let it go.
That's right. That's right.
Mr. President, I wonder if you could get one picture with everyone.
Yeah.
All right.
Let's do that, please.
Everybody's?
Yeah.
Sir? Oh, would you get over this side, please? Sure.
You're a little closer.
Thank you.
Please take
Thank you.
Mr. President, I'm listening. I'm much more chance than
you. There you go.
Thank you very much.
I'm from a pretty girl.
Well, because I have to say, those of us who were in television, there was always a thing when we met someone else that we haven't known before in television. Your first reaction was, hey, you're younger than I thought you were. I've come to the conclusion that unlike the motion picture camera, television is unkind.
It is.
That's true. I'm going to date him a little bit. I used to be president of the Geek Chapter at Knox College when you were over at Eureka.
For heaven's sake.
And that's where I still remember. That was the secret handshake. That's where I learned about running things. They call it the Preakness. He was the Preakness of the Peak Chapter.
You read it.
There you go.
But it's quite a few years ago called the
Yes.
Right.
Talk at Epsilon.
Right.
Now I guess the biggest return.
Oh, it is.
And it is said to be a fraternity for life.
Mm-hmm. That's great. And yeah, we all believe that.
So we want them up around here, don't we?
Yeah, I think you ought to say hello over there, and then while they're shaking hands, we'll stage in the back here. The little girl that's coming in, her mother works in the Office of Records here at the White House. She's worked here since 1975. I thought we'd do is give the little girl a jelly bean jar. There are the two pens, there's the proclamation.
Do diabetics have something like that?
Good thought.
Hey.
Whoa. Good heavens. I mean, I got another plan.
I think we've met before. This is Dr. Rash, who's the president of the American Diabetes Association. Bruce Jenner. Bruce Jenner. And this is one of your own. Your picture, Simpson, and your wife, her mother, Wanda. Wanda works here at the White House. Is that wonderful? And then President Steny Hoyer, who is the sponsor of legislation.
Well, I know I'm supposed to sign the proclamation, so
yes.
You better come over there.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the now you see we only do one hair with the pen. So there could be two pens signed.
One name, that he knows.
There. Yeah. That proclaims the week. Wouldn't you like to have one of those pens as a souvenir? All right.
Oh, very nice. You think she has something on her mind, do you, Takesha?
What do you know? What are you going to say?
This is for me. For Mrs. Reagan. Take that to her.
Well, the end, right?
Well,
two for one.
You topped me. Well, thank you very much. I am very happy to have those.
Thank you. Fine. Thank you so much, Mr. President, for signing the proclamation. Putting the money in the research. Is that right? Mm-hmm. Exactly. And we want to have all of the
awesome
champion spirit in there, winning the fight. Isn't that right?
It's, it's the same thing that is up there in the ceiling of the room. And it's a pin.
Thank you.
Mr. President, would it be possible for me to present you with the Charles Best Medal, which is the award from the American Diabetes Association for outstanding contributions to the whole area of volunteerism and altruism, which is a basic American characteristic which you've identified, which is the heart of the Voluntary Health Agency. And we in the American Diabetes Association are very appreciative of your work and emphasis in this area.
Well, thank you very much. I'm very honored to have you. Appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for your help.
Thanks.
Really appreciate it. We have our champion working for diabetes.
That's right.
That's right. Keep him on the road and so forth.
It's worked out very well. American Diabetes Association, Linda and I were asked a few years ago. And we've been blessed with our first child, and things had been going so well for us, we decided to sort of give back a little bit. And they've been keeping us on, and since then had a second son. And so
that's great.
It's a good organization. I'm proud to be a part of it. Thank you for your help.
It's
very
impressive. Wonderful. Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you so much
for your help.
Thank you
for your time.
And your support. Dr. Grant tells me he's happy with NIH also. Would you please? Steady funds it, and so does Jim.
Thank you. Pardon me, lost my voice.
It looks great. We were here last week on our sculpture from Chuck Lee.
Oh, yes. And I know what you mean to others who are handicapped, and what an example that you are for all of them with your accomplishments. And you have every reason to be proud. The other day, I think you'd be interested to know that I had a visitor here at the White House. He was the young man, also blind, who walked across the United States from his home in Idaho, hiked all the way to Baltimore, Maryland, to prove it could be done. And I think what all of you mean is that to anyone in our land who has any kind of handicap, the only word that any of us should use is rehabilitation, to do everything we can to make it possible for everyone to be independent and self-sustaining, and you are contributing very much to showing that that can be done. And I thank you all for being here. God bless you. Jimmy Stewart, and it was just that I had called. He's a great figure in Hollywood, as you know, great actor and everything, but Jimmy was also a great student. I mean, a great student, what do I mean? A great citizen of our country, and in World War II, he was in the Air Force. He flew the Hamburg Run, and flew B-17 bombers and all, and Jimmy, we all in Hollywood used to love to try to imitate him, because for those of you who've heard him, you know that Jimmy like that. One day we were all doing a benefit, and the person in charge said to Jimmy, said, "Now, Jimmy, you just have 2 minutes on stage." Jimmy says, it takes me longer than 2 minutes to say hello. Thank you all.
Good luck.
Yes, sir. Got them right.
Oh, did they?
Right. Have a good picture.
Yes. Here.
Well, I'm pleased to welcome you. That must have been a very exciting trip to Asia.
It was, and they are looking forward to your family.
Sir. Yes, I know. I've been briefing, in meetings, briefing every day on this. But,
I see the president's side over here. That's real
long. It's all right.
We'll be with you. Appreciate what you're doing.
Very much so. He's a Texan, so anything that looks like a saddle, why?
He's out to us. I'm trying to get prayer in school.
Yes. I brought a note to you, Fred, and the first paragraph says that if you want a 59-year-old ex-fighter pilot, I'm ready.
I'll read this later.
But we are deeply grateful.
We are indeed, and we'd bring you greetings from many of the people you will see. It was a privilege to try to be an American in the context in which you are living.
Well, I know what the World Alliance is doing for freedom of religion around the world.
This is an emphasis that we have sought to make, and we've rejoiced to find a high level of freedom throughout Asia, which came as a bit of a surprise to me, I might add, but we find out people operating in, with great freedom, Korea, as well as Japan, other places.
I made a comment here, Mr. President, about the freedom in Korea of religion. You know, they have a pretty strict government there because of their proximity to the North Korea. But we've been in and out of there for 20 years and not had any restriction at all on the propagation of the faith. And I wanted to make a comment. And in Taiwan, and they were excited about our meeting with you and the freedom that they have. And we expressed it.
How widespread is Christianity there in South Korea?
There's a report that the percentage gives the percentage in the United States a bit of a rise.
It is growing very rapidly. I gave you the figures.
Oh, there. All right. Now, what would their native religion be?
Buddhism.
Buddhism.
But the fastest growing Christian nation in the world is Korea.
The largest church, Christian church in the world, is in Seoul. 300,000 plus members, which makes no sense. I was told I would speak to 50,000 people on one worship service Sunday morning. I thought that's a nice figure, but I don't believe it. But having gotten into a traffic jam 6 blocks before I got to church with the people trying to get there, they are there.
Well, when 2 million turned out for that funeral.
Yeah. Yes, yes. You. Yes.
Well, here's some little souvenirs.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Presidential seal.
Oh, you're most kind, sir, and thank you for giving us all your time. I wore a pin to tell you that here is a mainline church denominational leader of 40 years who's been in your camp from the beginning.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I can't help but be right
here.
Thank you. All these people know the story. I have to tell you my little story. Because of what you're doing worldwide for religious freedom. Oh, this is a story that is, I collect stories that are told by the Russian people among themselves to show their, and it shows their cynicism about their own country. And this was one where a commissar visited the state collective farm, stopped a worker, said to him, "How, any complaints?" Oh, he said, "Oh no, comrade, no one. I've never heard anyone complain." Well, he said, "How are the crops?" Oh, he said, "The crops are wonderful, never been better." He said, "Potatoes?" Oh, he said, "Comrade, if the potatoes were put in one pile, they would reach the foot of God." And the commissar said, "This is the Soviet Union. There is no God." He said, "That's all right. There are no potatoes."
That's beautiful. Thank you, sir.
My wife brought you your first Christmas card.
We hope that's earlier than that.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you for coming here.